And they should be
I'm
fine.
gonna leave and go to one of the other rooms connected to the big main room in the middle.
Okay. Well, there is room 5 and 4A. Which one do you want to
go to? I'm gonna go to room 4A.
4A. Okay. So, as you open up the door to 4A, it is dark. Kind of dark.
Is there fire in the fireplace?
There's no fire.
Well, I wouldn't know. I'm gonna light it up the best with my... Actually, no, I get one of the arrows from my light crossbow and illuminate it using magical tinkering. Sylvie, you're my kid. And, I illuminate and try to fire it into the middle of the room, illuminating as much as I can.
Okay.
Do
you
have
to roll? Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
13. You do as what you said?
Okay.
So,
what can I see?
So, what you see is the kitchen.
Hello.
The kitchen is tidy with dishware, cookingware, and utensils neatly placed on the shelves, and a work table has a cutting board and a rolling pin atop it. You see a dome-shaped oven.
That's 4A.
Stands near the east wall and is bent. Its bent iron stovepipe is connecting to a hole on the ceiling. Behind the stove, there's something behind the stove. I don't know.
Alright.
Do any of us have enough strength to push it?
There's all the food that's in the pantry is pears, fresh foods. But everything tastes bland. Everything just tastes boring and bland.
If Luigi's Mansion has
still like sustain food.
Luigi's Mansion has told me anything.
It holds food. The food is like fresh, but it tastes bland.
Yeah, but does it like when you eat it, do you feel full or does it just feel like you're eating nothing?
I don't know.
I'm gonna eat one of the pears and find out.
So you take a pear out of the pantry and eat it.
Follow you guys.
No.
You take a potato chip. And you'll eat it!
Oh gosh.
I had to, I'm sorry.
Okay, so what do you want to do?
Can I see what's behind the cooker? The oven?
So, what you see is that there's a small door.
Would I be small enough to fit through?
You have to move the stove for him.
I'm gonna try with my strength to move the stove.
Okay, we'll roll for your strength.
14, yeah.
Is it 14?
Minus 1, so 14. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So, you move it a little bit, just enough for you to fit through.
Is Sylvie able to fit through?
Am I still in the previous place, or have you guys dragged me?
I'm pretty sure you're still looking at the fireplace.
Yeah, you haven't moved.
Yeah.
We've left. Okay.
Yeah, you just told.
Can I do a trip check as I I'm lighting it with my short sword, and can I do a trip check as I?
You can do a trip check.
I snap back to reality and wonder where you guys went.
Okay, so.
Walk out into where we were before we entered, and decided to pick a random room. And pick up the map, check the room I can go into.
Five. Okay. So, as As Crazy goes into room 5, it is dark, so you'll need something to light up the room.
Oh, I bring out one of my torches.
Okay. So, as you are lighting up your torch, what you see is a centerpiece of a wood-paneled dining room. It's a carved mahogany table surrounded by 8 high-backed chairs with sculpted armrests and cushioned seats. A crystal chandelier hangs over the table and is covered with silverware and crystalware polished to a dazzling shine. Mounted above the marble fireplace is a mahogany frame painting in the Alpine Vale. So that is what you see.
Am I able to see what's on the painting?
Yes, so the painting is carved with elegant images of deer among the trees.
What do I see, by the way, in my place?
What you see is, so this is the kitchen's dumbwaiter. It's a 2-foot-wide stone shaft containing a wooden elevator box attached to a simple rope and pulley mechanism that can be operated manually in a shaft that connects to a different area.
Can I go up the shaft then?
Make a dexterity check.
Dexterity, okay.
Yep. You said the silverware
is 3, 16.
So you get through to the dumbwaiter, and you go to the area.
Real descriptive.
Yeah, I know. You go to the area on the second floor, 7A.
7A. Okay.
That's cool.
Yep. Alright, so.
Would it be nice?
Sylvie's fixing his mic.
Anyway.
Okay, so as Falcor's doing that. What are you doing, Crazy?
What else do we see?
I don't know.
Well, that's. Well, then. You say on the table. There's silverware?
Mm-hmm.
Can I pick one up and see how high quality it is? If it is?
Yeah, mm-hmm. You can if you want.
Then I do that. To the most expensive looking one.
Alright, so I don't know, make a
is it a d20?
Like roll a d20, but I guess it would be investigation.
Investigation.
So you have a plus one.
Seven. I rolled, and the plus one is 8.
Alright, so you can't really tell if it's
quality of any kind.
Yeah, you can't really tell. Alright, so are you looking for anything else?
You said something about a fancy plate or something on the table, did you?
No.
Yeah. Then I go back into the room I was before. Nothing of interest in it.
Alright. So, Filter, what are you doing now? Since you're now in room 7A.
Is that like a I get out wearing my torches so I can see better and light it using my flint and steel.
Mm-hmm.
What do I see?
So.
Oh, wait, can I do a trap check first?
Yeah.
Trap check 7.
You don't see anything. You can't
okay.
tell.
You don't see nothing.
What do I see?
Is a undecorated bedroom. This is the servant's room. This contains a pair of beds with straw stuffed mattresses at the foot of each bed is an empty footed locker. The tidy servant's uniforms hang from the hooks in the adjoining area closet.
The locker is locked.
Damn it.
It doesn't say.
What are they?
And it doesn't tell me.
Well, you as DM have to decide.
I guess so. So they are unlocked.
They are unlocked. Okay. I open them and see what's in there.
Okay. You open it up and there's nothing.
No.
It's empty.
Well, I guess I'm gonna leave and go and see if I'm gonna go into 7B.
7B, okay. So, as you open up the room to 7B, all you see is the servant's uniforms that hang from hooks in the closet.
Okay.
Am I allowed to go up the set of stairs and into room 6?
Well, I was gonna do the same thing.
I'm also going to room 6 as well.
Alright, so you go up into room 6 and all of you guys meet up with each other again.
Hey, all right. I forgot.
I travel to the farthest wall after doing a check. Not say anything.
Oh, I'm gonna do a trip check as well, actually.
No.
No.
You don't say anything?
Okay.
But it is dark. Ish, so you can light the fireplace.
Yes, I would like to light the fireplace.
Alright, so roll for that.
What's around?
So.
Oh.
Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to light the fireplace in the room 5.
That's fine. It didn't have anything in it.
Maybe things valuable, but.
So,
hopefully not
as
anything.
You light up the room, you see unlit oil lamps that are mounted on the walls. You see hanging above the mantle is a wooden framed portrait of the Durst family. Gustav, Elizabeth, and Elizabeth, which are the parents of the two children you saw outside. So now you know what they look like.
Okay.
Can I take one of the oil lanterns and light it?
Does the one of the parents look
as
like
well
that old man?
Okay.
Does that one of those parents look like the old man from outside?
No.
Damn.
Not the old man.
And the kids, definitely. But not the old man.
See Gustav and Elizabeth Durst with their two smiling children, Rose and Thorn. Cradled in the father's arms is a swaddled baby, which the mother regards as a hint of scorn.
No.
What's that mean?
Standing suits of armor flanked wooden doors in the east and west halls. Each suit of armor clutches a spear and has a visored helm shaped like a wolf's head. The doors are carved with dancing youths, although the inspection, you don't know yet, so.
I'm gonna go to one of the statues and kick it over.
No, but actually, no. Before you do that, am I allowed to take, what type of armor do they have? If I was to take it?
It's probably just light armor.
Okay, then never mind.
Yeah, I may take one over.
Go for it, roll. Strength.
Strength. Roll. 13 minus 1, so 12.
You go to kick it over and it almost falls over, but then it goes back into its standing position.
Yeah. I'm gonna move into room 10 then.
Okay.
What do I see in room 10?
So.
That's the music hall.
I have to find it first.
I'll go into 8 after.
Okay. So, room 10.
I shall follow Falkor.
Ah, yes. Leave me alone.
That cover over the windows of this elegantly appointed hall, which has a brass plated chandelier hanging from the ceiling. Chairs line the walls and stained glass walls hanging despite beautiful men and women and children singing and playing instruments. A harp with a bench rest is in the northwest corner near the fireplace is a large standing harp. You see figurines of well-dressed dancers adorn the mantelpiece.
Am I able to do a strength check to carry the standing harp with me? And take it.
You can try.
What else is in there?
So nat 20.
Nice.
You go to pick up this harp, but as even though that with your strength you try picking it up, it seems as the house has
it's attached to the house.
It and it's holding it down even tighter, so you can't pick it up.
It's attached.
What else
to the
is
house.
In the room? You see, there's
chairs. There's chairs, there's another, smaller harp, and there are figurines of well-dressed dancers.
Can I try and play the larger harp?
If you want to.
Do I have to roll?
Yeah.
Roll for performance.
18.
So... You have a plus 3 in performance.
Which means a 21?
Yeah, 21.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
And of course, I'm not in that room to hear it. Fuck.
It is an amazing performance.
Yeah.
Yeah. You just play it really well.
Yeah.
Does anything unlock? Like any doors.
From the looks of it, all of those every almost
I don't know,
every
you
room.
Have to get closer.
From the looks of it, almost every room has a.
Can I light the fireplace?
Yeah.
Yeah. But
doors,
as you go to light the fireplace, though, you see that the carvings that I said before of the dancers are actually
the figurines.
Yeah, are actually carvings of well-dressed skeletons.
Oh boy!
Huh.
I burn them with my torch.
No, don't do that.
You will have the house kill you.
Why?
What do you mean, why? Okay, so...
You go to do that.
Playing the hat really well. What room playing the hat really well make the house Eight. Like me.
Mm-hmm. You go, so... Falcor goes to do that, and just the floor underneath him opens and it just swallows him.
So,
yeah, that would
crazy,
not be good.
You went into room...
Eight.
Eight, yeah, okay. So, as you go into room eight, you see, this used to be the where the master of the house would spend his hours. So this is what you see. Red velvet drapes over the covered windows of this room, an exquisite mahogany desk, and a matching high back chair facing the entrance and the fireplace, above which hangs a framed picture of a windmill atop a rocky crag. Seated in the corners of the room are overstuffed chairs, floor to ceilings, bookshelves line the south wall, and a rolling ladder, wooden ladder, allows one to more easily reach the high shelves. The desk has several items on top of it: an oil lamp, a jar of ink, a quill pen, a tinderbox, a letter kit containing a red wax candle, four blank sheets of parchment, a wood seal bearing the Dirsch family insignia, which is the wood mill. The desk drawer is empty, except for an iron key, which unlocks a door to a different area.
Yeah, we'll
the
take
bookshelves
the...
hold hundreds of books ranging topics including history, warfare, and alchemy. There are also several shelves containing first edition works of poetry and fiction. The books rot and fall apart if taken from the house.
So you can only read them there.
Okay.
Can I go into that room with Rustin?
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. Can I
I light the fireplace.
And alchemy.
Yeah, you can light the fireplace, just roll a d20.
Eight.
So as you go to light the fireplace, you kinda almost burn yourself and something on the side of the fireplace.
Yep.
Can we have a look at those
pat down the fire that's on me and whatever I almost burned.
Okay, can I see if there's any books on spellcasting?
You can.
I will also take the wooden key that's on the desk. All and right. Examine it.
I got 19.
So as you go and look for a book, you don't find the book that you're looking for, but you actually find a secret door behind one of the bookshelves.
Try and open
you,
it?
You can try to open it.
No, that's
a strength check.
That's to room 9, I guess.
Hold on. Nope. Perception.
Perception check. One. Critical fail.
It can be unlocked by a swung open pulling. It can be swung open by pulling on a switch. Decides to look like a red covered book with a big spine. Just saying.
Can I attempt to open said door?
Yes, you can.
Alright, what do I roll?
Perception.
Nat 20.
Okay, well, as you're going through the books, you accidentally hit one of the books that opens up the actual door, and you find Area 9.
It's right behind
the serpent's room.
Oh.
Okay, so,
what's in there?
So.
Trap check.
Oh yeah, trap check.
13.
Okay.
For trap
okay,
check.
Yeah, you see nothing there. So this room contains bookshelves packed with tomes describing summoning rituals and necromantic rituals of a cult called Priestess of I don't know how to say the name, I can't.
Type it in chat.
Do I have the ability to learn any of these spells?
The rituals are bogus, which you can look at it and study it for an hour. If you succeed in intelligence or arcana check.
Intelligence or arcana check. So yeah, I'll do that. Do I get like a spell if I do? What do I get for doing
it? You can ascertain after studying like anything. You can look at the books, study them, and see if you can,
Wait, I'll do it.
Yeah.
I roll... Oh, a 3.
Yeah, no, you don't learn anything. You also see...
Yeah, no, that's fine.
You don't learn anything.
Should I add that key to my inventory? Or do I need to roll something to make sure it's not a trap or something?
I just have your inventory, right? Panda?
Wait, what? Sorry.
Is Crazy adding the key to his inventory?
Yeah. So, what you also see is a heavy wooden chest with clawed iron feet that stands against the south wall, and the lid is half closed. Sticking out of the chest is a skeleton in leather armor.
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Wait, trap check first. I haven't done a trap check in this room. Oh no, I did.
I did a trap check and it was 13, so.
Yeah, I also got 13. Yeah, can I
as you get closer to the skeleton, the skeleton belongs to a human who triggered a poison dart trap. 3 darts are stuck into the dead adventurer's armor and ribcage.
Can I take
the dart firing mechanism inside the chest no longer functions.
So you can still open the chest.
In the skeleton's left hand is a letter bearing a seal of words I can't say.
Type it in chat.
It's too hard to read.
Ash dreadful on the side of each.
Whatever, I'm just skipping it. Anyway. Which the adventurer tried to remove from the chest. Written in the following script, the letter reads as follows. My most pathetic servant, I am not Messiah sent to you by the dark powers of this land. I have not come to lead you on a path to immortality. However many souls you have bled on your hidden altar, however many visitors you have tortured in your dungeon, know that you are not the ones who brought me to this beautiful land. You are but worms withering in my earth. You say that you are cursed, your fortune spent. You abandoned love for madness, took solace into the bosom of another woman and sired a stillborn son. Cursed by darkness? Of that, I have no doubt. Save you from your wretchedness? I think not. Much prefer you as you are. Your dread lord and master, Juan Skrzarkovich. I can't say words, but
Stratford
I will...
Savage.
Whatever. I will send you a screenshot of the letter so that you can...
I burn the letter.
Why you burn the letter? You're gonna make the... You're gonna make the place mad. Don't burn the letter.
The chest contains three blank books with black leather that covers.
Can I read the books?
They're blank books.
Oh, they're blank. There.
There's 25 gold pieces.
25,000.
I'll take them.
No, I'll. Can I try and swipe them without anyone realizing?
You can try.
You can try. Yes.
Sleight of hand.
Sleight of hand. Oh yes, I get +3 to my roll. 5 + 3, so 8.
Yeah, no, that didn't work out.
Can I take them with people noticing them?
Four plus.
Yes, that'll be as a chance.
Hand,
I guess
+3. That is, 7.
7. So Sylvie tried and got worse.
Hey, did I get worse than you?
I got 8 total. 5 + 3, so 8.
Oh. Well, shite. Well, that was the sleight of hand rule.
Yeah. So you see 3 spell scrolls plus protection from poison and spiritual weapon.
Oh,
the
each
deed
could
to
take
the
one.
House.
The irony of dying to a chest with poison protection
house,
or dying of poison
the
dust.
The deed to a windmill and a signed will. The windmill referred to the second deed is situated on the mountains of the east, like of east of this place. Like not the house, of like somewhere else.
I burn the deeds.
No, wait, we need to read them first.
The will
don't burn the deeds.
Actually no, you're right, they're expensive.
It's a bit durst. And
well,
and the windmill and all other family property to Rose's family, like the Durst family, an event to their parents' deaths. The book scrolls deeds will age remarkably if taken from the house.
But they won't disappear. Will the deeds like disappear completely, or will they still be like?
They will be aged.
Old.
And old.
So,
but
so they'll still be recognizable.
Will...
They'll still be teeth.
But they'll remain intact, so it's not like they just
okay.
Kind of light and fire.
While Sylvie tries to get the gold, can I try and swipe the deeds without him realizing?
That wouldn't work because you're both in the chest.
Okay, can I try and take the deeds while Sylvie's intelligence is too low to him for him to realize that they might be valuable?
You know, I feel called out.
My intelligence is like 11 points higher than yours. It's fine.
I would like to say mine is 13. I don't know if that I can make
a
difference.
Yeah, you're a nice average. So yeah, can I try and take the deeds then? And does Sylvie have to roll to realize that they might be valuable?
You can take them and know because they're deeds and wills.
They're wills. Oh, wills. Well, like, I can sell
there's
the deeds to them,
right? And then there's will. There's a will.
Oh, there's a will. Can I read the will?
Yeah, if there's a will, there's a way.
Oh, well, I already told you what the will was signed by. It doesn't say anything else.
Oh, is the will the letter?
No.
Oh. So it's just a will with nothing written on it.
Is it just a people?
There's a will. It's there's something written.
Is it a paper that?
But it doesn't tell me. Like I'm not. I'm being serious. Nothing tells me.
Well, then you make it up.
No.
Is it a piece of paper with a well drawn on it?
You know,
like I'm that creative.
While Crazy and Falkor try to get you to read the will, I head out of room 9 and out of room 8 and up the stairs.
I'm just in a character.
The third floor. Okay. So.
I follow him.
You
I'm gonna take
go up into room 11.
Mm-hmm.
What you see is when you're going up this staircase, it starts to get really dusty, and
so
you get up, I think it's right directly in front of you. You'll see a
black armor,
a suit of black armor, yeah, standing against the wall, draped in cotton.
Jake, follow him up as well.
So the suit can of animated armor attacks as soon as it takes damage.
Wait, what?
So it attacks as soon as it takes damage.
So don't kick it.
Am I able to take the armor without causing it damage?
You can try.
Oh no.
Do I roll?
But if you succeed.
Well,
if you...
yeah, but
how
like,
close
what,
are you
what...
to it?
I mean, you could always walk up to it.
Yeah, I walk up to it.
Yeah, walked up to it. So,
Did you roll?
So if he succeeds in getting the armor, but ends up getting caused damage during it, does it just come alive?
Well, if I'm wearing it and it gets damaged, it attacks whatever. Damages it,
but then you wouldn't have any control, would you?
Yeah.
So,
but that would be good.
As you get closer, armor. Sylvie, to this armor, it attacks you.
Roll initiative.
Oh. Yep.
So, I'm in the same room.
So it's already hit you. Well, it's going to hit you anyway. And let me see.
D20. 7. It hits me.
That mean we had to.
Initiative. I got 16.
Oh, you also have to do
well,
that.
Wait,
initiative.
No, it's going against your armor class. Your armor class is a 16. I have to beat that.
Oh
no! I got a 16, yeah. So I hit you.
Natural one.
Oh no! Well, you two, since you guys aren't in the fight, you guys don't roll initiative.
Well, okay. No, I followed Sylvie up, though.
Well, yeah, but did you go right behind him, going
yeah,
up to the armor?
Yeah, well, no, I didn't go right up, but I'm in the same room.
Well, technically,
yeah,
I left.
So, you're in the same room. He's fighting the armor, but you're not.
Oh, okay. I'm just gonna stay out of the fight then. Don't need to fight.
Yeah, I'm out of the
fight. Just only attacking Sylvie. Doesn't give a shit about me.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, instead, we'll go into either 15A or.
So, what happens?
So, it is going to hit you with Slam.
Hey, we have to.
It does 4 points of damage.
Oof.
That's a pretty nice looking dungeon, monster.
So 4, and if I'm at
that's like a JoJo stunt.
21, then it's wrong one. If I'm at 21 minus 4, I am now at 17.
Yeah.
pull out my great axe and I attempt a swing.
Okay. Roll a d20 for me.
D20. 12.
You miss.
Oof. Oh.
Yeah. Sorry, buddy. What are you guys doing? Since you guys aren't in the fight, you might.
Oh.
Please help me.
Want to help?
I carefully walk past Sylvie and into. And walk into room 12A.
I follow him.
No matter what you're gonna do, you end up being in the fight.
So I do have to roll for initiative now.
Yep.
Fuck.
You gotta roll.
10.
Okay, you're behind the wall.
18.
You're in front of Sylvie. Okay. So. So, the armor missed. It didn't hit. So. Falcor, your turn. Roll.
Oh, my turn. Yep. Roll. What am I rolling for? Wait, what?
To hit?
You're in the fight.
Oh.
You're in the fight.
Okay. Right. 20. 1, 6.
Miss. Crazy.
Five.
You miss. I miss. Sylvie, your turn.
Wait, I thought I was in front of Sylvie.
11.
Yeah, you are. You miss.
Oh, my turn again. Can I try and cast Thorn Whip to pull it close? I think that's a terrible idea. I'm going to. Can I use Thorn Whip to try and pull off one of those pieces of armor to try and weaken him? Okay.
Roll d20.
1.
You miss.
I rolled a 19.
Crazy, your turn.
I rolled a
19. Wait, 19.
That was a crit fail. How did I not hurt anyone else?
I rolled a 19. What would chill touch do?
Let me check again.
Because I feel like if I do Ray of Frost, it might hit Sylvie and.
I'm surprised my Thorn Whip didn't hit anyone since they got a 1.
Yeah, no, you kind of just missed and hit the wall behind you.
She's not that mean of a DM.
Not that mean. Okay, so chill. Wait, you're doing chill touch?
I mainly want to see what it does.
So it does. So. It does. Let me see. You create a ghostly skeletal hand in the space of the creature within range. You make a ranged spell attack against the creature to assail it with. The Chill of the Grave. On hit, the target takes 1d8 necrotic damage, and it can't regain hit points until the start of your next turn. Until then, the hand clings onto your target. If you hit an undead target, it also has a disadvantage on attack rolls against you until the end of your next turn. The spell damage increases by 1d8. And blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, I could do that.
I won't do that.
Spooky beast. Wait, one moment.
Yep. So
spooky. No character sheet. I don't know how to bring that up onto here. But right now here's the map. No, I can't do that. Lame. Here's the map so far. It's in this house.
What did you roll?
Death house.
He's muted.
This stuff.
He said he's gonna be back in one sec.
Okay.
Yeah, I was just talking to the chef. Hey, what do you roll?
Yeah, 1d8.
Which one is that one?
Triangle faces.
Yeah. So think of two pyramids stuck together.
The diamond.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Three. I think I should have something.
Now, animated armor is now stuck in place for right now. It is going to try attacking Sylvie, and it missed, so.
That's extremely blurry.
My turn.
Yep.
Another 11. I miss.
Okay, I'm gonna use my shorts. Is it focused on Sylvie?
Yes.
Can I try and get a bind and sneak attack it?
It is against a wall.
Oh, it's against a wall. Okay.
Yep.
I'm gonna try and get my short sword and jam it in its face hole.
Face hole.
You know what I mean.
Okay. Yeah, 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 I know what you mean. Face. So roll.
Roll.
See if you hit.
Say stop.
No.
You miss.
Don't say stop.
Crazy, it's your turn.
Four.
You miss.
Alright.
Let me roll. I miss. So.
Okay. What would be a critical fail if I was to use my fire weapon? My breath weapon.
Yeah. I believe it's 5 edition. I am
a
silver dragonborn.
So the fire.
Silver Dragonborn sorcerer, ice master.
So you'll end up getting everyone.
I believe I can.
All right.
I don't know how to show.
So yeah, it's a 15 foot cone.
Yes.
Yeah, you'll hit everyone.
Will I? Even if I like.
If you
even
back
if
up.
I get a nat 20.
Maybe not, but if you back up. Any, you will hit them. But
okay.
If they back
so
up
I'm
behind
not...
you, then.
Then I'm not gonna use my breath weapon yet.
Yeah.
I pull out my long sword and shield, and I swing.
All right.
14.
You miss.
Is it my turn?
How high do you have to have? Wait. Holy shit.
Can I pull out my light crossbow and take a shot?
I think it's my turn, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Falker's turn.
Can I use message on it?
No, you cannot.
Why not?
It does not speak any languages, it's armor.
Oh.
It's just armor.
It might have been,
Can you speak the language of armor?
Can you speak the languages of dash dash?
Let me check. No.
Can you just go up to it and just go rattle rattle and see if it says anything?
Can I try and kick its head off?
You can try. It's stuck.
20. I got an 8.
Kill upon dragon.
8.
This is his dog.
Yeah.
Wow, the power. I don't know how to show my character sheets to the stream. Because this
put it in its own Windows caption.
I don't have.
Your chill touch has now wore off.
Ah, how?
Time.
It only lasts a small duration.
Yeah. Did it do damage, though?
It did do damage.
That's pretty good. Yeah, let's see, what else do I have as spells? What does Ray of Frost do? It sends out like a blast of frost, right? Selby, your mic.
Yeah.
What does it do?
Pretty sure you're.
Ray of Frost.
Pretty sure you're in front of me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he is. A frigid beam of blue-white light streaks toward a creature within range. Make a ranged spell attack against your target. On hit, the target takes about 1d8 cold damage, and his speed is reduced by 10 feet until the start of your next turn.
I could do that. Mm-hmm. So it's like a blast of energy instead of just like a wave of it. Okay, I can do that. Let's see if I hit it.
Roll to hit.
Who has my stream open?
Me. You got a one.
Ouch.
You tried to hit
it, but your spell just didn't even work at all. It just kind of, you know.
So I tried to do like a Hadouken, but it's like.
Yeah, but nothing came out. Like, nothing.
Or a Hamei, Hamei.
Alright. So.
Damn it.
Nope, I missed. Okay.
Alright. How high do I have to get to hit?
I can't tell you, I'm sorry. I'll tell you after, but right now I can't.
I got another 14.
You miss, I'm sorry. This might take a while. I might bring down the armor class.
Do I have to get it above a 16?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, my turn. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna try and use my thorn whip to take its head off.
You can try.
Come on, 20. Better. 7. For fuck's sake!
It missed. Crazy.
Keep hitting the fucking side.
Do you have to hit the book now?
18.
I might bring down the. Oh, you barely hit it.
Barely hit it. Oh, what are you with the ray of something frost. That's what it is.
Ray of frost. Okay, roll one.
Hamei, Hamei, Hamei. 5.
All right.
Ha!
The only person that so far has hit this is crazy.
Yeah.
Irony, I guess.
Alright, my turn. I'm gonna die. Got a natural one. Okay.
Alright, what do I. So, I'm gonna swing again.
Okay.
I reduced its speed, so hit the fucker.
Yeah, you missed. Falcor, it's your turn.
Okay, I'm going to try.
Casting mod.
And, can I try and escape the battle into the other
rooms? I
don't
know.
No, you cannot, because it will get an attack of opportunity on you.
Oh.
And then you'll be back in battle.
Right, just fucking divinity, are we?
Panda, where do I find like a casting mod?
Okay, I'm going to.
Your casting modifiers?
I don't know, because my viewer asked, what is your casting modifier at? I'm not sure what that is.
I don't remember. So it is your charisma.
Your charisma?
Right.
If it's charisma, it's +3.
Yep.
Well, there you go. Spooky. It's plus 3, I guess.
What's mine? Out of curiosity. Is it also charisma?
Yep. No, there's also a plus 3.
Okay.
Mine is 2.
Yay. Right, I'm going to I guess just attack it with my light crossbow.
Alright, roll the hit.
Alright, 16!
Oh,
you missed.
Just hit it.
What? Alright, I thought 16 was the amount you need to hit. Or is it above 16?
It's above 16.
Oh, damn it.
Do you want me to just tell you what it is?
Well, it's 16, right?
No, you have to hit above 18 or 18.
Yeah.
I might bring that down though, because I feel like that's really high.
Yeah, it might is.
So I might bring. I think I'm gonna bring it down to 16. So Falcor, you do hit.
Oh yeah.
That is unfair.
How much damage do I do?
So you're doing crossbow.
So, 1d8 passing.
That's not good. I can't open it.
7.
7. Good job.
Yeah. Wait, what's the plus 3 attack bonus?
Oh, I had that on top of it. So.
Oh, so 11.
Good to know I can't stream
I
with
can't spell.
Chrome on. No.
Alright. Okay, so Crazy, your turn.
Ah, okay.
I've done the most damage. Useless in fights.
Ah, damn it, 10.
You miss. I just barely hit Sylvie.
Lovely. Okay.
Yeah. So he is to.
How much health does it have? Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I'll tell you after.
Well, how much are you hit for?
I have no idea. I don't remember that.
How much did
I see the first time it was 3 with a chill touch. And second time was Ray of Frost with end 5.
Okay, so that's 8 plus 11, so 19.
He takes 3 points of damage, sorry.
Alright, I'm at 14 now.
14 health, oh jeez. Okay.
Alright,
Oh, my turn.
No, it's my turn.
I'm. Yeah, I don't know what I'm thinking.
Who is in front of me and who is behind me?
Falkor's behind you.
By the way, Spooky.
Crazy's in front.
Hi.
Okay.
Welcome to the stream.
Oh, Crazy, you better get behind me.
I get behind.
Turn.
You can't yet.
Oh, yeah. When?
Yeah,
it's time
to get behind him. Yeah, you have to wait. Wait.
Oh, well, I miss again.
Oh.
Doesn't matter.
By the way,
I'm
Spooky.
I'm going to.
Pleasanton,
right?
Yeah, by the way, Spooky.
Yeah.
How do you like the stuff so far?
Let's see if I can.
From what you've seen.
Do anything in the first place. I can't, I got 2. Fun. I was gonna try and like thorn whip him again to take a bit of armor off.
Crazy.
How long have we been going
yeah.
for?
Oh, it's my turn.
It's your turn.
Oh, we've been going for
6 hours, isn't it? Now?
6 to 5 hours.
Yeah. Jesus.
Damn
I'm
it.
Okay.
5.
Yeah, we'll stop after this.
Yeah, I'll stop after this fight.
Jesus Christ.
Oh my god. Yeah, 20 minutes.
Oof. Yo, what did you roll, crazy?
5.
Yeah, you missed.
Yeah.
I got a natural 1. So, Sylvie, your turn.
Alright.
Did Liam hurt himself at all?
Yeah, sorry, Spooky.
Did he crit fail?
No.
Maybe next time we could, like, actually have a physical map.
Another fail.
Oh my god. I'm just gonna try and punch his head off.
Go for it.
5.
Yes.
18 for me when I go.
You hit. Alright.
Oh, thank god. Just murder him, please.
Let's see, what can I do? Burning.
Are you supposed to, like, see what you're gonna do and then do the dice roll?
I mean, if I hit it, if I miss it, I don't do anything anyway.
Yeah. Like, you can then decide what to do. Now that you know that you've hit.
So burning touch. Burning touch. What does that do?
Burning touch.
Do I just have to physically touch it? Or?
So it's burning hands. Alright, so let me see.
Can everyone stick to snakes at all? At some point.
That would be fun.
That's my favorite spell.
But if
the burning hands is a 15 foot cone. Like a breath weapon. As you hold your hands with thumbs touching and fingers spread, a thin sheet of flames shoots forth from your outstretched fingertips. Each creature within a 15-foot cone must make a dexterity saving throw. A creature takes 3d6 fire damage, well, for you it would be cold damage, on a failed save, or half as much damage on a successful one. The fire ignites any flammable objects in the area that aren't being worn or carried.
So, maybe not the best idea to do that in a house.
In a house.
Well, it'd be anything gets covered in ice.
Well, technically, it's like frost ice. It's basically like fire, but it's also very cold.
Oh, well, yeah.
Also, turns out sticks to snakes is only for clerics and druids, so.
Sad. I'm just imagining if I use Mage Hand and just slap it across the face. Can I do that?
Let me see. So, Mage Hand. You touch a willing creature who isn't wearing armor. Well, this is armor. The protective magical
it's force. Only armor.
The spell ends. So.
I would imagine no.
Protect.
The target. Wait.
It is armor, so I would imagine it doesn't work anymore.
Right. Oh, for some reason, I was thinking mage armor. Jeez.
Right. Yeah.
I was reading the wrong one. Okay, mage hand. Okay. This is a spectral floating hand that appears at a point you choose within range, which is 30 feet. The hand lasts for the duration or until you dismiss its action. The hand vanishes if it's ever more than 30 feet away from you, or if you cast the spell again. You can use your action to control the hand. The hand can manipulate an object, open a door or a container, stow or retrieve an item from an open container, or pour the contents out of a vial.
So
you cannot hit it.
Damn.
Sorry.
Nighty.
Well, can it carry a sword and then swing?
Or carry a sword and just thrust forward.
Yeah, if you don't, like, throw it.
No. Ah, that's interesting.
It's mainly just to, like, carry stuff, open doors, stuff like that.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
I guess I could do either chill touch or ray of frost. But yeah.
Diamonds are worth upwards of 1,000.
No, why not? Chill touch again. Chill touch. That's a D. What?
A D8.
Roll to hit. Oh yeah, you already.
Well, he already
hit,
rolled
so.
It.
Yeah, I'm just gonna have to roll that. Crazy.
What did you get?
A one.
Well, that didn't do much.
Lovely.
Alright, it is the thing.
So, if it's saying it's to hold something,
yeah.
The mage hand, if you used it to hold down an enemy to attack him, like you yourself, would that even do anything?
No, it has to be an object.
Even with,
well,
even with
technically,
the...
isn't this an object?
I guess so. But it wouldn't hurt anything.
But you wouldn't. But it itself wouldn't be hurting anything. It'll just hold it in place.
It would be holding it in place, I guess.
Oh, it's not strong enough to grapple. Says Spooky.
Oh, well. There you go. I'm gonna try
That's
and shoot.
That's what I was
my...
thinking, but.
I'm gonna try and shoot with my crossbow again.
It's the armor's turn. I have a roll.
Yeah, it only holds.
It missed anyway, so it's your turn.
Apparently, Mage Hand only holds about 10 pounds.
My turn.
Yeah, I can't hold
Fall
my
core.
No. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Good to know.
I miss.
You miss, okay.
I'm gonna try and. Truly his bow. 12.
Oh, by the way.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Beautiful. Oh, roll to hit.
Yep.
Yeah.
7.
Miss.
You miss.
I miss.
You know, for a suit of armor without anything in it, quite missy.
I put away my sword and shield, and I pull out my great axe, and I roll a 10 and miss.
Ouch.
I get closer to try and attack it with my short sword, I guess.
Right.
And I hit. Oh god, that's a 4 miss.
Crazy.
Oh, I do it again. God damn it, natural 1.
I missed, Sylvie, your turn.
Alright. I swing again with my great axe, and I miss.
Is there anything around that I could use that would make, like, is there anything I can make land on top of it? Like, is there a chandelier or something?
Like, no.
Can I do a perception check?
Which one of my items does most damage? Does the Ray of Frost do more damage, or the Chill Touch?
Can I try and use
it's
the
same for both Ray of Frost and Chill Touch?
Can I try and use the Thorn Whip to like pull some floorboards underneath it to make it fall over?
Or you can wrap around its leg and pull.
Yeah, then I will just miss.
Can you choose what I'm looking for?
Can I try and like? Grapple into the floorboards and like try and pull them out to like trip up the armor. Or is that impossible?
Yeah, but you'll pull it closer to you.
I promise tomorrow when we do this again,
will it hurt it at least?
That everything is gonna be much better than it is currently.
Four. It doesn't even matter.
Alright,
yeah.
Crazy.
If the dot is underneath the... Either way, it's either a 6 or a 9, I forget. It's a 6, right?
The
miss.
Below it.
If the dot is on the bottom, it's a 6, right?
Okay, yes, a 6. Yeah, it's on the bottom.
Either way, I miss.
Yeah, a 6 is when the dot is closer to the loop, and a 9 is when the dot is closer to the tail.
Yeah, it's a 6.
Wait, no, it's the other way around.
No?
Yeah,
no, 6. It's that way, how you said it.
Six is closer to the loop, and nine is closer to the tail.
I thought you said it the other way around. I got confused.
Confusion.
I am confusion.
I just found the door.
Right. So, Crazy goes, he misses. Falcor go.
Oh my god.
No, it's me.
Nathiama, and then you.
Sorry, I barely missed. Sylvie, your turn.
All right. I'm just gonna say I rolled ahead of time during Crazy's turn.
Yeah.
And I got a 19.
Okay.
I was gonna say please be a natural 20, so we can go again.
So close to a natural
20. So close. Oh,
okay. Well, what are you doing?
Fucking crush it, please.
Great axe.
12 plus 2. Mm-hmm. Why is it so blurry?
1 second. I deal 6 damage total.
Okay.
Really?
It's kind of looking stumbly.
My turn. I'm just gonna try and kick its head off again.
Okay.
14.
Device info.
Miss.
Hey. Crazy,
your turn.
Okay. Yeah, let's do that one. It's. What? This time it's a 9. That's not working for whatever reason. Of course, Of course, the one time where it fucking hits the wall or something, it rolled a fucking 20. Ugh. But yeah, I missed.
Yeah, I missed too.
No, because Sylvie, kill it, please.
Still trying to like.
All right. What is the damage on a heavy crossbow?
Let me check.
Wait, I can check.
Jam it in its eye socket so you can't miss.
That's armor. No, I don't want armor. I want.
Okay, so it
heavy
is...
crossbow is 10 piercing.
Yes.
It's a D10 piercing.
Okay, good.
So I'm gonna get a D10 ready.
You don't know if you've hit though, do you?
I know. I'm just getting one ready because
Alrighty, spooky. Thanks for joining
as well.
I love ya.
Appreciate
ya.
And I got a 12.
Got it.
My son.
I feel like tomorrow when we do this, we should have like an actual board.
Well, yeah, we'd have to use roll 20 though.
Yeah, Spooky, the my viewer, who's been commenting over this, he left, but yeah, he said he could help with that if we need it.
That'd be nice. Yeah. I got a 16. I was gonna shoot with my crossbow again. So, but it is, was it again a D8? Yeah. D8, right. D8 plus 1, plus 3, rather. 11. No, wait. 9 total.
9.
Yeah.
Alright. How do you want to do it?
Oh, wait, is it actually dead?
It's dead.
Yeah. I want to make sure nothing of it remains.
I don't care.
It's pissed me off too much. I want it to be a fine powder by the time I'm done with it.
But I want the armor, please.
Then roll to stop me.
You won't be able to have the armor.
Why not? Like, if it's a ghost, then it'll just kill the ghost inside of the armor.
But the armor
it'll probably disappear out of the house, yeah. So I was thinking
fine.
Just disappear.
That's so a thing. That's,
yeah, can I grind it into a fucking fine powder?
If you want to, yeah.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Alright, so as you go to hit it, you are so angry, you just grind it like it's nothing because you're so pissed. Alright, and that is where we're going to end it for today.
Lovely.
Yeah. How was there more any other piece of shit armors?
Well,
oh my God.
You can go into a previous room that you've been to, and you guys can rest there and get up your HP.
Yeah.
Alright.
Well, none of us was hit. The only person who was hit was the one who kicked
me. Yeah.
No, shush.
Yeah, me and Crazy just tried to sneak past and let you deal with it.
Yeah, and which I don't get why you wouldn't at least try to.
Well, no
me.
Matter what you would have done, you would have gone into the range of it because that is still 5 feet away. You would have gone in no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, his armor class was 18. I brought it down to a 16 after a bit because I'm like, I'm done with this.
Jesus.
And his health was 33.
Is that actually how armor class works?
Yes, it is. You roll to hit, and if you don't hit above the armor class, you miss.
Damn it.
Roll the DRS, the attack bonus. The result equals. Wait, no, it's with the attack bonus, though. So if they had an armor class of like 16 and I rolled a 15, but my crossbow had plus 3.
But you're rolling to hit. Not with the.
Its function hasn't changed. The better your armor class, the harder you have to hit. When an attack is made, the attacker rolls a 1d20 and adds their attack bonus. If the result equals or exceeds the armor class, the target is hit. So yeah, it's with the attack bonus though.
Because how I've always done it is that, or how I learned how it was that if you don't hit above the armor class, you just don't. That you didn't add anything else to it.
Oh, but it says here to add the attack bonus. Which can we please do? Because that fight was a nightmare.
It was a painfully long.
Yeah.
Can we add the attack bonuses of our weapons? No. Thank you. So my crossbow has a plus 3. Okay.
Attack
good.
All right. Bonuses.
So, yeah, we're done for tonight. We can do okay. Or something.
Oh.
Let's all go into room 6 and rest there.
Okay. I which room 6 was that?
The
one
main
down.
Hall
on the
below us.
I want to go to room 10
second
and
floor.
Up some more.
There's the one downstairs. We could.
I got a 1 while playing my harp.
Yeah, we could do that.
It's absolutely garbage.
Yeah, I'm not even trying. I'm just. I break some of the strings.
Oops.
Now
yeah,
the elf kills you.
Fuck. Anyway, I'm gonna. Yeah.
Anyway, that was fun. Even though it's.
That is a nightmare.
We definitely should.
Almost 6 hours.
Almost 6 hours.
I was only gonna do 4, but then we had that long break. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It wasn't that much. It was only like 20 minutes, wasn't it?
Yeah, but it was still a long break.
Yeah, it was still pretty long.
Like playing the game because the game commentary takes forever.
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah. And then my stuff fucking cut out midway 3 hours in.
Yeah.
3, maybe 4 hours in.
That kind of sucks.
Yeah.
Anyway, alright, well, that was fun.
Yeah.
Panda, do I need to send you,
yeah, do I need to send you updated character sheets as well?
Yeah.
If you want to. I was keeping up with most of it, but...
Okay, well,
I don't think
I
got everything.
Yeah, I've been
yeah, I just want to send it to you so that,
You can send me a screenshot of it and then I'll update it.
I'm in VR.
We're supposed
to. I kind of can't send you a screenshot.
We're supposed to write on it.
Also, I can't send a screenshot either because some of my stuff scrolls off in my inventory.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing to add onto it is a key and to add 75 to the natural thing and the spells and stuff, but you know.
That's okay.
You have that already.
I'll be back.
But yeah, so are we doing this tomorrow?
We can.
Yeah, we can.
But yeah, if we do it tomorrow, we should do it on Roll 20.
Yeah, that'd be much easier, I think.
Yeah.
Panda, if you want, I can help you with Roll 20 to create the maps.
Maybe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We can do that after, or.
Yeah, we can do that.
Like, I can just teach you how it all works. If you want.
Yeah.
Panda. Okay. Because you'll be running everything. I'll be back, and I assume when I get back, all of you will have left call and Panda will call me, so.
Alrighty. Okay, don't forget to end the stream. Please.
Yeah, okay. I already ended the stream.
Oh. Then I should just end the stream. So, anyway, that's basically the end of the stream. If you liked it, leave a comment down below. Tell me where to go, what it's about, what you improve on. Thank you guys for coming. Nobody's watching. But hey. So. Thank you. It's actually been really fun, guys. Awesome. If you can see that. Oh yeah, I meant you guys. Yeah. Thanks for inviting me to the stuff. And me actually doing it. Yay! Yippee. what else? Yeah, that's basically it. If you want to see more, tell me. So anyway, keep smiling, don't forget to be a little crazy, and hasta luego!